Welcome back, everyone. If you could please like and subscribe, I would, as always, really appreciate it. So in today's video, I'm going to be comparing the new Nanlite 720 with the Forza 500. I'll give you my disclosures right up front. Nanlite has sponsored me to speak before at an event, and they provided me with both of these lights. I'm going to sort of compare and contrast the two and give you some real-world test results and exposure reading, so hopefully that will help you make a decision when looking at whether or not you should get the 500 or the 720. So first off, the 720 is quite a bit larger in its physical form factor. Of course, it's also consuming about 50% more energy, 720 in versus 500 in. You'll notice that the light, or the part where the light comes out on the 720, is a little bit larger than the 500. I think that's gonna play in to my test results. But before we get to that, let's talk about the differences physically, more so between the two lights. This one locks with a lever. The 720 has this handy lever on the side that just locks us into position, and it's very rigid and feels very secure. The 500 uses two knobs, one on each side, in order to secure the position. It also clicks as you kind of tilt through to sort of give you a little bit more sense that you're secure. The way that the two ballasts or dimmers attach to the stands is different as well. With the 500, it sort of had this locking thing that wrapped around the stand, and then there was a slot in order to hang this strap. With the 720, it is quite a bit different. There is a super clamp that goes on and locks around the stand, and then the ballast clicks in, and of course you also use a release to unlock it and pull it out. Now on the 720, the cables seem a lot more robust, and the ends sort of have a very nice locking mechanism, and it feels very, very secure. With the 500, I was never really sure if I had it pushed in all the way or not, although it's not like it really causes a problem. It's just that it doesn't feel as nice as it is on the 720. So let's go ahead now and start off with our test. I'm gonna start off by doing a test using hard light and a Fresnel lens on the front of each of these lights. I'll be doing the test at 15, 16 feet or 5 meters from this wall back here. The purpose, or the reason why I'm doing this, is because Arri gives their photometrics for their lights at that distance and in flux. So for our first test here with the Nanlite 720, I'm going to be using the FL20G Fresnel. I've got it turned here to 15 degrees. I got 6800 lux with my meter, and I got a photo exposure of 1/60th of a second at f6.3 at ISO 100. Then I also got a film exposure of 1/50th or 1/48th of a second at f7.1 at ISO 100. After turning up or zooming in here to 40 degrees, I got 3200 lux and a photo exposure of 1/60th of a second at f4.5 at ISO 100, or a film exposure of 1/48th, 1/50th at f5 at ISO 100. Then with the Forza 500 and the Fresnel at 15 degrees, I got 6300 lux and a photo exposure of 1/60th of a second at f6.3 at ISO 100, and a film, movie camera, video camera exposure of 1/50th, 1/48th at f7.1 at ISO 100. At 40 degrees, I got 2400 lux and a photo exposure of 1/60th of a second at f4 at ISO 100, and a film exposure of 1/50th of a second or 1/48th f4.5 at ISO 100. So at 15 degrees, there was virtually no difference between the 720 and the 500. But at 40 degrees, the 720 was about 1/3 of a stop brighter. So on spot or 15 degrees, the Arri Sun 5, according to the manual, is capable of producing 3,432 lux. However, The Forza 500 and 720 are capable of producing 6300 or 6800 lux respectively, which is about a stop more of light. When we sort of flooded out there a little bit to 40 degrees, which is what Arri calls medium, we got very similar results with the 720, more so to the Arri M8. And they say that the M8 is sort of equivalent to a 1.2K old school HMI. Now, I don't see much of a difference or a great difference between these two units with the Fresnel on there. And I think the reason is that I'm just gonna go out on a limb. I didn't talk to anybody and I don't have any inside knowledge, but I'm just gonna guess, because before I compared the Forza 500 with the FS300, and I'll link to that video. This has a much smaller chip on board, I think it's called, this light where the light's coming out, than the FS300. And because of that, it was a lot more efficient in the Fresnel. And I'm guessing that this one, even though you're putting more power in, because the light source is larger, that perhaps it's not giving us as much like oomph as a hard light, but the results might be different than when we use soft light. So let's go ahead and test that out next. All right, so I designed this test, or thought of this test, more for my photographers out there, but of course, this will be applicable for videographers who are often lighting a subject's face at about this distance with perhaps a softbox like this 90 centimeter parabolic from Nanlite. So I'm gonna go ahead and measure the distance from Sia here, who's looking a little rough lately. And of course, the distance from her chin to the bottom of the modifier, or the modifier here in general, is about 1 meter or 40 inches. So let's go ahead and check and see how bright it is. So if I were to meet her here, right on her nose, pointed to the modifier, it would be 1/250th of a second at f2.8 at ISO 100. Or if I convert that down to a shutter speed or a shutter angle for videography, it would be 1/50th at 5.6 at ISO 100. So very, very bright in general. So let's go ahead now and see what it is with the 720. And hopefully it's about a third of a stop brighter. I guess we'll find out together. All right, so I've got the 720 set up now with the 90 centimeter parabolic. We've got Sia here. She's just been hanging out. Let's make sure it's the right distance from her nose. And that does meet her 40 inches or 1 meter from the softbox. It is feathered a little bit. The center of it's pointed right about here. So it's a little bit high and in front of her face, which is normally how I light things. I light it so that the back edge is equal with the front of the face and the bottom is equal with the jaw. So for a photography exposure, let's start off by metering that here. And it is 1/250th of a second at f2.8 and 7/10. That would be 3.5 on your camera and ISO 100. Then for video, we're looking at about a 1/50th or a 1/48th of a second at f8 at ISO 100. So it is quite a bit brighter. Now, I think that you can use continuous lights for photography in a number of situations. For instance, I found that if you're using ISO 400, for instance, and you don't underexpose it, you get pretty much the same look as you would with 100 ISO. So right now at ISO 400, it would give us a shutter speed of 1/250th of a second at 5.6 2/3. And that's really a good shutter speed for getting depth of field and sharpness in our shots. And that shutter speed, I'm sorry, that f-stop is good for getting us depth of field and sharpness in the shot. And then in addition to that, that shutter speed, 1/250th, that's pretty good for freezing most things in general posing. If we were trying to photograph a dancer jumping through the air, it's probably not gonna be bright enough. And maybe if we pointed a fan at her, it would be iffy. Even someone who's moving like this, that could be blurry at 1/250th. But an adult who's stationary, this will work out really well and give you a lot of light to work with. So you may have noticed in the last test that the feathering of the softboxes weren't exactly the same. And so I decided to run it again. And this time I used a second light stand to mark where the softbox should be located. That way, the feathering with the two lights would be exactly the same. I also measured to make sure that the bottom of the modifier was in exactly the same spot, 54 inches. And when I ran the test again, I found that the Forza 720 was 0.8 of a stop brighter than the Forza 500. So now that we've concluded our tests, who are these for? And which one of them should you buy? Well, if you're gonna be using hard light with a Fresnel like the FL20G, there really, of course, wasn't that big of a difference between the 500 and the 720. But if you're gonna be using soft light, let's say for photography, the 720 is a much better choice because you're gonna get 2/3 0.8 more of a stop of light, and that's gonna allow you to either stop down a little bit and get more detail or speed your shutter speed up a little bit and freeze the motion of the person posing. Or you're gonna be able to use 2/3 of a stop lower ISO, and that's gonna help just to boost quality overall. If you're a filmmaker or a videographer, having 2/3 0.8 of a stop more soft light is gonna be great in a number of applications. So a lot of times on this channel, I'm sitting in front of my window over here with the light sort of coming from behind me out the window, and you can see outside, and I'm lighting myself from the front with the 90 centimeter parabolic. Well, having 2/3 0.8 of a stop more light is going to be key for me because I'll be able to hold more detail in the sky and the scene that is out the window. In addition, when you're comparing these two units, the build quality on the 720 is a lot better. And even though I have nothing to base this on other than a gut feeling, I just feel like the 720 is made better and it's probably gonna last a little bit longer. That would be my sense of things. And of course, this handle up here is a lot more robust and can probably hold a larger, heavier modifier. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, just leave those below. And as always, stay safe, have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon.